The polls have only been open for a few hours, but already Facebook is being flooded with an incredible number of obnoxious election-related WAP posts and status updates. Jason Copeland has some tips for surviving this onslaught of unbearable garbage. Jason.
Well, thank you, Andrea. Your friends on Facebook simply can't shut the fuck up today, but you can limit your exposure to their inane status updates, misattributed quotes about democracy, and self-righteous reminders to get out and vote with these simple tips. Tip number one, immediately block anyone who posts about the election. Now, that includes horrible, irritating liberals sharing unbelievable Mitt Romney stories that everyone else has known about for months, as well as horrible conservative martyrs. And Andrea, viewers need to be prepared to block even their closest loved ones today, as that disgustingly smug video where that guy forces his three-year-old to say she loves Obama could be posted by your own brother.
Now, Jason, is it just people on Facebook who think everyone needs to hear their worthless opinions?
Well, Andrea, the trend we're seeing on Twitter is that everyone thinks they're fucking comedians.
I see.
That's why tip number two is to stay off the microblogging site all day today, likely into tomorrow. Right now, the number one ranking hashtag on Twitter is "You know she a slut if she vote for," where people hypothesize the kinds of things sluts vote for, like dicks and shirts that say ass on them.
Oh, that is truly annoying stuff, Jason.
Absolutely.
But is there anything viewers can do to avoid these uninformed, semi-coherent diatribes?
Well, Andrea, that brings us to tip number three. Avoid every other website on the internet today.
Okay.
Some jackass has already posted about the election there. This post found on Red Lobster's Shrimptoberfest page, "Hateful Muslim Obama wants to sell our futures to China. Don't vote. He is monkey."
All right. Thank you so much, Jason. These are great tips.
Well, thanks, Andrea. And one final piece of advice before I go. You know, I know it's going to be tempting, but whatever you do, do not make a post yourself that points out the hypocrisy of all your lazy, uninvolved friends making a big deal about Election Day.
That's right.
Remember, that just makes you part of the problem.
Great work, Jason. Now, remember, everyone, if you must use social media today, simply reread your own posts over and over again like you do anyway.